UFC Welterweight Championship Showdown between Leon Edwards and Tyron Woodley. So here's the former University of Missouri wrestler, one Tyron Woodley, first realized the UFC belt back in 2016. And this is a guy who poses a lot of different threats for this UFC welterweight division.
He's a problem. He's a guy that's very tough to prepare for because he has a great wrestling background, but he has this athleticism and this ability to put your lights out with that big right hand that you cannot even focus too much on stopping takedowns. Tyron Woodley is truly one of the best welterweights in the world, and one of the
start of this fight. I'm anxious, man. What a matchup it is, and it's going to be interesting, and it's going to be interesting to see who has the upper hand.
It's going to be difficult to find out how this plays out, right? Striker versus well-rounded fighter. Who's going to be the one that's going to control where this fight takes place?
Really timing his shots nicely. Good tempo, very accurate. Body kick is blocked. Well, it's one thing to have length, it's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Edwards. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the killer.
Oh!
So both guys landing at will here. Good action early.
Look at how fast. The only person I can do this to is Baby John. John, there's a weight difference. I don't know if you know jiu-jitsu much. You can slide in your class. If I'm gonna do this to anybody, it's Anakin.
All right, he's got the hooks in, DC, working off of his back.
Well, you gotta start clearing those hooks right away, or he's gonna start trying to attack the rear choke. He is doing a really good job of relaxing, not panicking, because he's getting choked. Which is exactly what he's doing, and it looks like he has the arm under the neck.
Well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Keeping busy here off of his back. Nice offense from the bottom. Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. Well, he's staying pretty effective here, fighting off of his back. Nice strike landed there by the bottom by Wood. Well, you know, I don't like the gi very much, but I have an appreciation and a healthy one for these type of transitions.
You can tell he's been in a gi at some point in his life with the way that he moves so freely.
I'm skipping jiu-jitsu next week, too. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
In fight numbers for you now, 29 total strikes have landed for Tyron Woodley.
Ooh, head kick lands, he's hurt.
Oh, head kick. And that one was heavy. Oh, big left. Keeps going back to that jab, keeps throwing that jab, but unable to land. Edwards gets in the clinch yet again.
Big powerful punch land. Now we get back to range.
So 3 minutes off the clock in our first round.
Look at the whip action that comes after that kick.
Oh, beautiful striking there by Leon Edwards. He has really become a well-rounded welterweight. You saw in the Gunnar Nelson fight how good his wrestling defense was.
So try to take him down. There you go.
Oh, massive slam. That'll change the complexion of this one. All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy.
Right now, it looks like he may be trying to set up an arm triangle choke. He needs to secure the left arm, push it across, and secure it with his head. Watch triangle, watch triangle. There he is. He's moving to the finishing position. Now watch, he goes parallel right there.
And he's out. combination of ground and pound strikes here, DC, this could be the beginning of the end.
I mean, you got to be very careful when you take these big ground and pound strikes. You need to control posture on the bottom. And if you're the top guy, the guy that's looking to finish, continue to gain posture and rain down big strikes on your opponent.
All right, working out of side control here. His opponent trying to control posture, but you got to be careful here. All right, good movement by him here on the ground. He really is a master of these transitions.
He is a master of movement on the ground. You never know where he's going to be.
Oh, huge knee to the head.
Good right hand.
Big elbow. Now he's got the Muay Thai block. So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll as this fight goes on. That horn sounds means we have reached the end of round one. All right, let's now look back at some of the action from that round. He went headhunting, landed, nearly got the finish too.
A lot of coaches tell you don't headhunt. In this case, he's been headhunting, and he landed a big enough shot to truly put his opponent on notice. Big punch lands.
Big strike lands.
Big strike lands. Now he looks to try to chase down that pitch. He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
72 total strikes, as you see there, have now landed for Tyron. While certainly picking the spots well tonight, landing with 64% accuracy against Leon Edwards. Oh, that's a good counter there. The straight punch lands by Edwards.
He had the turnover in that kick.
Edwards going to the kicking game now. Certainly earned the respect with his hands. Now changes the level.
Full on mixed martial arts.
Yeah.
He can do it all. He's a fantastic striker. A guy that can mix it up. A guy that knows exactly where to open it.
Whoa!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down.
Woodley gets hit with a kick here. Let's see how he responds. Back to the feet. Strikes, but his corner's looking for him to mix it up a little bit more and just throw more volume.
Because they don't see too much of a threat. This guy has to have confidence in knowing that when he extends his combinations, he's still safe, but he's also going to be able to land. He's got to be finding that confidence in his mind that all the reps in the training room are going to pay off. That was a nice strike.
Looping left hand misses the target.
Look at him working at trying to shut the liver down.
Oh, nice straight there by Woodley. Well, he has really picked up the pace here in round two. Much more aggressive than we saw in round one, and now starting to find himself in the pocket.
Big kick.
Under 2 minutes now to go. And he landed the right hand there. Right hand upstairs.
knows isn't going to be able to take too many more as he doubles up on the jab there.
So good to watch MMA evolve and watch guys now fight behind the jab.
Big elbow.
Every time these guys come together, man, you just hear the punches and everything landing. Both very powerful, very, very explosive.
Just out of range with that right hook.
Huge block there.
Effective punch there by Edwards. All right, single collar timeout.
Grabbing the back of the head, pulling forward on the head, and then landing a beautiful punch.
It up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Wilson gets the takedown, could be big here. Edwards has got his arm under the chin, going for guillotine now.
Watch guillotine.
Oh, man, that was slick.
Yep, and he's got him secured in the half guard now.
All right, dominant position here. He's got the full mount. A lot of different ways he can go here. Maybe try to find an arm bar or just get the ground and pound.
He can attack submission. But those submissions will present themselves once he is landing that Bruno Bravo pound he is known for. Because then his opponent will start to get a little bit desperate to get out from under him, which will then in turn leave arms dangling, or he'll turn to his knees and get choked out.
Well, I'm not sure the extent to which he has recovered, but we do see the end of the round. DC, talk us through the replay.
Well, he's a tough guy. He's going to make it to the stool. He's going to survive unless you put him completely out of there. Unfortunately, he's in there with a guy that does have that ability.
Here we go, third round of this championship fight. Punches in bunches, and he hasn't really shown any signs of slowing down here tonight. I'm not sure how much more his opponent can take. Oh, and he lands a punch there. Good connection by him on that.
Great connect, so fast, so accurate. Watch the ability to land anywhere. It's a beautiful, fast, quick jab with meaning.
Throws the right hand there.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots. Over the top. This fight's going to be over.
What a great way of mixing up his attack. He didn't stay the course. He mixed it up. He went high when the opponent thought he was going low. And now he's got him hurt very badly.
Oh!
Beautiful punch.
Numbers unofficial, but they look right to me. 135 total strikes have landed for Leon Edwards. And I'd also add landing with 62% accuracy tonight against Tyron Woodley. Woodley gets hit with a kick. That one appeared to land flush. Oh, beautiful jab there from Leon Edwards. And if you don't know the name Leon Edwards, you're going to start to hear his name increasingly. Truly one one of the better fighters in this division.
Absolutely. And the reason we don't know his name is because he's more of a quiet guy. He's very reserved. He used to be at AKA for months, and you barely knew that Rocky was even there. He was just there to kill.
Just over 3 minutes to go in round three. 3 minutes to go in the round. Misses with the right hand. That shot blocked by the chosen one. Try to establish that jab. Oh, continuing to work the body to great effect. Edwards gets caught with that punch. Don't be afraid to get that job on to get the takedown there.
He did a good job of setting up his... Now he's attacking the triangle.
Triangle looks pretty tight, DC. I'm no Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt, but maybe not good here.
No, it looks like he's getting in deep.
This could be trouble. And he's out. Woodley's lower jaw looking extremely swollen now. Close guard.
Now look at him jumping in to try to get the finish.
Back to the stand-up now. Both fighters upright. Pretty good ground and pound by him here. He told us on Thursday he needed to be more effective in these situations. Certainly effective tonight.
Many people have gone away from this style of fighting. This man has embraced it, and you are seeing why. One of the best that we've seen do it in a long time.
Oh, nice job working hard, posting, and getting back. An elbow!
Dude's hurt. Serves him up. Go get him.
Just a gorgeous shot there to end the fight. Really just the way he drew it up. He found the opening and capitalized on it to the utmost extent. Nicely done to finish the fight. Oh, we'll take a look back at the highlights. You know we're going to find that nasty head. The official decision is in. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bugliotta has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 21 seconds of the third round. Declaring the winner by knockout and steal.
UFC welterweight championship showdown between Leon Edwards and UFC president Dana White. All right, so here he is, the number one welterweight contender, getting set to challenge for the UFC's 170-pound title. Took a long winning streak in many years for him to realize this opportunity. He is not taking it lightly. He has said all here during fight week he's appreciative of this opportunity, but he is confident he is going to maximize it. So here we go as round one gets underway. Two world-class level strikers here, and the expectation is we're going to get a kickboxing match here in the octagon.
Yes, we are going to get a striking match. One guy is very good at kicks. The other guy has unbelievable hands. Let's see what type of attack is going to win the battle of two great stand-up fighters.
Oh, that's a good strike there by Edwards.
Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick.
Dana White gets caught by that straight punch there. All right, he engages in the single collar tie.
No give on that leg kick. Nice kick.
Now goes in and secures the takedown. All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
And he's back up.
Straight punch lands.
Oh, beautiful jab there from Leon Edwards. And if you don't know the name Leon Edwards, you're gonna start to hear his name increasingly. Truly one of the better fighters in this division.
Absolutely. And the reason you don't know his name is because he's more of a quiet guy. He's very reserved. He used to be at AKA for months, and you barely knew that Rocky was even there. He was just there to get his work in, as he's doing his work now inside the octagon.
So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Leon Edwards. Dana White gets caught with that punch. Not the easiest guy in the world to hit, but he got caught there. Man, he is so sound defensively. Nice job to raise the guard there.
It's the relaxation that allows him to see things coming and block most of the strikes that are coming at him.
Oh, tags him with the straight. Nice job there by Dana White. Oh, that's a nice straight punch there.
Threw the punch, got to the target. Oh, that was a big takedown. Is this the one that's going to break him?
Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation.
Right now, it looks like he may be trying to set up an arm triangle choke. He needs to secure the left arm, push it across, and secure it with his head. Watch triangle, watch triangle.
All right, so he postures out, he's out. Well, you know he's comfortable fighting off of his back. Oh, tagged him with that right hand. What a strike that was.
What a strike that he is landing over and over again. His opponent will need to make some adjustments.
Oh, he's got it going now. Nice connection there, DC.
Another punch landing.
Man, is he timing his shots well here tonight, DC. It's hard to recall him being this accurate in the past.
I mean, he is so sharp. And not only is he accurate, he's also keeping very busy.
Punch no good. Straight right is there. Misses with the left hook.
Nice punch lands over the top.
Punch is blocked.
You gotta check these low leg kicks.
That is a hard left hand that lands for Leon Edwards, and as usual, DC, let this fighting do the talking tonight.
Let this fight do the talking, and he's all business. He's a businessman. He's here to win, go back to England, and do his thing with his family. He's not going to be on TV hooping and hollering. He's a guy that's here to do his job, and then go back home until he gets the title.
Nice punch by Edwards.
Massive elbow landing.
So we cross the 30-second mark in our opening round. And that one certainly found the target. And he lands yet another hook there. Flush. Nice job by Dana White. Oh, the uppercut is clean. Final second to round one.
Ah, that jab hurt him.
Collar tie. All right, so there's the end of the round, and the tide has officially turned. A huge head strike to stun his opponent. We'll see which corner can adjust here moving forward.
I mean, they've got to be celebrating. They've got to be happy. Everything's working. But the other side has to be concerned. They have to figure something out, make some sort of adjustment to try to change the tide of this fight.
Second round underway. Oh, and he connects with a punch there, DC. You gotta like what you're seeing, Muscle.
I mean, the speed at which he throws is crazy.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. How good is that right hand?
I mean, he's cutting them down to size with these beautiful leg kicks.
Oh, I love the jab. I know you love the jab. That was a nice one.
It's my favorite punch in all the fight.
Oh, nice jab.
Got the single collar tie.
Big punch lands over the top.
As effective a straight punch as we've seen all night.
Huge straight punch lands, and he's got to hurt very bad. You take more of these leg kicks, you will not be able to be very active on your feet.
Edwards gets touched by that kick there. Oh, combination lands, and it seemed like almost every strike found the target.
He's so accurate when he decides to attack. It is a sight to behold.
Good series of strikes by him there.
Great job of mixing it up, staying active, keeping busy, doing great work. Big ball punch lands. Now we get back in range.
And that he comes through with a big knee.
That knee hurt him.
Just out of range with the big right hand. Wow, that right punch has been the money weapon for him tonight, and he landed it again there.
If his opponent does not change something, you will continue to throw the strike until he makes it. Stop doing that. Look at how he turns his hip over when he throws that kick. He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
Edwards gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up. Oh, he lands another strike to the body. Really starting to connect on a lot of shots to the midsection. And these will take their toll as this fight goes into the latter rounds. Pretty good right hand. UFC President Dana White's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots.
Well,
the right hand is big. Spotting up the gut. I'm not sure his opponent knows where he is.
No, he doesn't know where he is. He's hurt real bad. That punch landed in the perfect spot. Oh! Oh!
Oh, straight right. Well, he's really starting to land a high number of strikes here in the second round. No denying that he has taken the message from his corner and picked up the pace here in round two.
Great punch landed with so much power.
How about that chin? Well, he's always working off of that jab. Nice jab there by Edwards. Just out of the range with that right hand. So again, the combinations have been largely kicks from him tonight, and it's certainly been working for him.
We don't see that very often. Normally, guys are punching. This guy leads the dance with his kick.
Just out of range with that uppercut.
Beautiful strike.
Well, he's certainly keeping busy, DC, connecting with most of the punches he's thrown.
I mean, punches in bunches. He's doing a great job. Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Flush with the head kick there, DC.
Beautiful setup to get his leg up there quickly before his opponent could react.
They continue to exchange. jab by him there. He's going nose hunting tonight, huh?
Yeah, he's great with the jab.
Big strike lands.
Big strike lands. Now he looks to try to chase down that pitch.
Wow! How about those 5 minutes?
All right, so there's the end of the round. He stayed committed to doing damage upstairs and landed a seminal blow in that round.
It was accumulation of those strikes. He kept hitting it over and over to the head. Eventually, he found the one that really did damage his opponent.
Here we go, third round of this championship fight. Well, he hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. He continues to connect on a high volume of strikes here.
Great punch.
Well, he misses with the left punch there. Effective use of the jab there by Dana White.
Nice head kick.
His back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape.
He jumps on a headlock. We call this in wrestling just a headlock. And if you're not careful, you can get stuck in an arm triangle.
Oh, nice job.
Now he's okay. Now he can escape.
Oh, nice combination of ground and pound here by Edwards. Useful strike there. The ground and pound on point tonight. UFC President Dana White gets caught with that punch. Gotta shore up the defense. Good series of strikes for him there. Staying busy and staying accurate.
I mean, the accuracy is unbelievable.
Big knee! All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent. You gotta be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. All right, closed guard now. You gotta be careful, though. He's got a lot of submissions off his back. So he's sort of turtled up here. Not great body language. Perhaps he's trying to bait him in a little bit. Both fighters get up now. Well, it's all pace and pressure down the stretch. He is really lighting him up now. Nice punch there by Edwards. And now they are throwing both sides with conviction.
Because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, he might be out. Oh! Edwards is kicked to the body here. That one appeared to be blocked. Oh, big knee!
Every time these guys come together, man, you just hear the punches and everything landing. Both very powerful, very, very explosive.
Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
All right, closed guard now. Edwards gets back up again. And he connects there, DC.
Great job landing that.
Oh!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right.
Oh! I'm not sure his opponent knows where he is.
No, he is on Beach Street right now. He's seeing three birds over the top of his head. When you take a hook like that,
there. Huge block. Oh, that's got to be discouraging as he gets looks like he's trying to set records here, landing all of these strikes. He is a goal. He's out.
Tolbert, oh my goodness. What a fight.
Just an absolutely gorgeous shot to spell the end for his opponent. Crowd is absolutely loving it. He gets the near perfect land. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming, but just the way he drew it up here tonight, saw that little crack of an opening and barged right through it to get the knockout. So there he is, the undisputed UFC welterweight champion. What a finish he turned in here tonight as he gets it done by way of knockout.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop this contest at 4 minutes, 28 seconds of the third round, declaring the winner by knockout, and still the undisputed UFC welterweight champion of the world, Leon Rocky Edwards.
All right, so there he is. He came in the hunted. He remains as such. Congrats to the still UFC welterweight champion. Big effort out of the incumbent here tonight.
He has so much pride in being the UFC champion, and you see it in the effort that he puts in retaining his title. One of the best welterweight champions in UFC history.
Coming up next, it is a UFC welterweight championship showdown between Leon Edwards and James the Texecutioner Vick. All right, so here he is, the number one welterweight contender, getting set to challenge for the UFC's 170-pound title. Took a long winning streak in many years for him to realize this opportunity. He is not taking it lightly. He has said all here during fight week he's appreciative of this opportunity, but he is confident he is going to maximize it and leave as not just a contender, but a UFC champion. The reigning, defending, undisputed UFC welterweight champion in a division full of killers. He has remained the hunted at 170 pounds. Now, unquestionably staring at his toughest challenger to date, can he go back home as the champion? If he can, another chapter to one of the greatest welterweight legacies the Octagon has ever seen. So here we go with round one, classic matchup of striker versus striker. These guys have both faced a lot of grapplers in the past. They like the draw tonight.
Oh, yeah, they love seeing an opponent that will not be trying to dive at their leg. They know when they get to the center of the octagon, the only steps back they will take is if they choose to move out of range to re-enter back into the striking realm. It's a very comforting thought for both of these competitors. Big kick lands.
And that one certainly found the target.
More strikes to the head.
Edwards gets hit by that kick to the body. And he landed the right hand there. Oh, a beautiful jab there from Leon Edwards. And if you don't know the name Leon Edwards, you're going to start to hear his name increasingly. Truly one of the better fighters in this division.
Absolutely. And the reason you don't know his name is he's more of a quiet guy. He's very reserved. He used to be at AKA for months, and you barely knew that.
Oh!
He was hurt. Serve him up. Go get him. Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
So a combination of kicks from him, and most of those found the target, DC. The kickboxing is on point tonight.
He's so sharp, and he feels so good that he's throwing multiple kicks in a row.
Just missed with the leg kick.
Big power punch land. Now he gets back to range.
Vic gets absolutely pelted by that head kick. Double leg takedown attempt here, and that is a good attempt as he gets the fight back to the mat.
It's ideal. His ideal situation just happened. He got it, and now he has a headlock trying to pin his opponent's back down flat onto the mat. Look from the transition to an arm triangle to try to chase the finish. A triangle, a triangle.
All right, so he postures up.
Oh, man, that was slick.
Well, he's staying pretty effective here, fighting off of his back. Nice strike landed there by the bottom by Vic. Edwards has got the full mount. Oh, the ground and pound strikes continue to rain down. The opponent better move out of harm's way or the referee's going to stop this.
He better start to move. And when his opponent starts to posture, he needs to put his feet on the hip, push him away to try to escape this very, very dangerous position.
Nowadays, you see guys just throwing little shots that don't really matter. Very few guys now are committed to ground and pound as they were in the past.
Just over 2 minutes, round one. Back to the feet now. 38 total strikes. Gets on the feet, his opponent in a lot of trouble now.
That was Cain Velasquez's punch of choice. Every time he landed that overhand right, he hurt people bad. And this guy has his opponent hurt very badly again.
Oh, loaded up on that uppercut, but it's no good. Knee there to the chest.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Oh, trying to turn out the lights with that roundhouse kick, but just misses. Wow, huge head kick.
He ate that kick. He took that whole kick, yep. Big kick lands.
Nice hook. Oh, straight right.
Oh, nice right hand. Oh, man.
And he comes through with a big knee. Oh, straight right. Trying to establish that jab once again. Edwards goes to the takedown here and gets it late in the round. All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got
it. Right now, it looks like he fades. He tried to set up an arm triangle choke. He needs to secure the left arm, push it across, and secure it with his head. A triangle, a triangle.
So there's the end of the round. He stayed committed to doing damage upstairs and landed a seminal blow in that round.
It was accumulation of those strikes. He kept hitting him over and over to the head. Eventually, he found the one that really did damage his opponent.
Second round here. Edwards gets caught with that punch. Tags him with the straight. Nice job there by Vic.
Big body kick land.
Oh, he's wearing it now, bleeding from his cheek. Well, he's been pretty accurate tonight. He's landed some significant strikes, but his corner's looking for him to mix it up a little bit more and just throw more volume.
Because they don't see too much of a threat. This guy has to have confidence in knowing that when he extends his combinations, he's still safe, but he's also going to be able to land. He's got to be finding that confidence in his mind that all the reps in the training room are going to pay off.
So unofficially, 63 total strikes have connected for James Vick. Well, the accuracy rate, you'll have to take my word for it. It's a huge shot there, DC. I'm not sure how he stayed up.
I mean, when you get hit with a shot like that, to stay standing shows and talk to your toughness.
Lands a good series of kicks there, DC. Really didn't take him good beat on his opponent.
He thinks,
yeah, looks a little wobbly on his feet.
What a fantastic strike.
All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. Side control now. Oh, and he's able to land a strike there from the bottom. Nicely done by Vic. Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Man, doesn't take a lot of these kicks to produce redness. Look at the left side of his body there. Nasty.
What a punch.
Nice elbow in the clinch there up top by Edwards. Well, his corner was pretty urgent after round one. A little bit lackluster there in that opening round. He has certainly picked up the pace here, and as a result, he has taken control of this second round. Whoa, there as he lands, and maybe time to get the bonus checks ready.
I mean, this fight is about done. He's got to hurt very bad. Now he has to find one more strike to end the night.
Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. We'll see how he chooses to defend here. Just over 2 minutes now to go in round two.
He's going to start looking to try to attack a rear naked choke, and that's exactly what he's doing. He is doing a really good job of relaxing, not panicking because he's getting choked.
Well, you gotta be working off of your back. He's certainly doing so here. Nice punch. Recovery, man. Right back to his feet.
Punch over the top.
Oh, big knee!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad. Every time these guys come together, man, you just hear the punches and everything landing. Both very powerful, very, very explosive.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. 60 seconds. Under a minute to go in the round. Oh, that cut is looking nastier by the minute.
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. All right, dominant position for him here, full mouth. If you're the bottom fighter, better start moving those hips, DC.
Oh, you got to start moving those hips. What you should do initially, right, is start to push at the knees. Push at the hips, create some distance, shrimp, and try to recollect half guard. Half guard sucks, but it's much better than being mounted fully by your opponent.
Edwards is back in full mount. All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
Oh, good opportunity to do damage here. He's got that tie clinch. All right, there's the end of the round. We'll show you some of the highlights. It must feel pretty damn good to knock a man down like that.
It feels good to knock a man down. And most times you don't even feel it. It's the ones that you don't even recognize that landed hard are the ones that usually put your opponent out. He landed right on the sweet spot, and he hurt his opponent very badly.
Excellent work. All those rounds on the pads in the gym have paid off.
Are you ready? You ready?
Here we go, third round of this championship fight. Well, he hasn't really showed any signs of... Oh!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, straight right. Oh, right hook attempt, no good.
If you take more of these leg kicks, you will not be able to be very active on your feet.
Vic's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling.
Straight punch lands.
Man, how about the crisp boxing, the kickboxing of Leon Edwards here tonight? It's amazing how much he has improved since his UFC debut a few years ago. And really has established himself as one of the best welterweights in the world. Oh, he landed another great shot to the body there. Really starting to connect at a high percentage now in the latter stages of this fight. Well, seems like more than that, but unofficially 115 total strikes have now landed for Leon Rocky Edwards. And in terms of the accuracy rate, DC landing at a 59% clip thus far tonight against Jamesville. All right, so he connects with another punch there, kind of targeting that cut.
I mean, when you get a cut on your opponent and you see it.
Whoa!
Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
All right, he engages in the single collar tie. Now goes in and secures the takedown. Fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted.
Well, you got to stay busy on the bottom. He's doing it here. Nice punch.
He jumps on a headlock. We call this in wrestling just a headlock. And if you're not careful, you can get stuck in an arm triangle.
Gets up again here, but he looks for... Oh!
What a sweep! Oh, look at him jumping in to try to get the finish.
All right, looks like he's got a couple hooks in here, DC, and defensively, you better be careful. Good movement by him here, transitioning very well on the ground tonight.
Step for step, he's staying with his opponent in every transition.
Oh, and now he's starting to get back. The referee has seen enough. Winner by TKO.
And a great performance by this young man.
YTC, no telestrator tonight, but we're going to get you some highlights from this one. This was a fight that had it all, and for my money, his best performance to date.
His best performance to date in the biggest moment. In the biggest moment, you got to show up, and that's exactly what he did tonight. He used every bit of his skill to get the job done.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 44 seconds of round number 3. Declaring the winner by knockout and still the undisputed UFC welterweight champion of the world, Leon Rocky.
So he came in the best.
best welterweight in the world. Nothing changes tonight. Congratulations to the still UFC welterweight champ.
He understands that he is the best fighter in the world at 170 pounds, and he proved that tonight.
So here we go, round one of this highly anticipated tilt between the strong striker and the decorated grappler. Any chance that these guys mix it up, or are you just expecting them to stick to what got them to the dance?
I'm expecting a pretty straightforward approach from both of these fighters. The striker will try to lead with his punches and his kicks, and the grappler will try to time a takedown, time a clinch position so he can start to work towards a lot of those great judo throws that he's got his chin in, but now it's starting to slip under the neck.
Getting touched here repeatedly with these ground and pound strikes from the top. Referee's not going to bail you out.
Now, you see guys just throwing little shots that don't really matter. Very few guys now are committed to ground and pound as they were in the past.
The ground and pound has been there all night.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here. And he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
Connects with a right hand. Pretty good punch, that one.
Nice right punch by this young man.
All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent. You got to be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. All right, he's got side control here, DC. You know, he's got a lot of different submissions in his arsenal once this fight gets to the ground. Well, he continues to manhandle him here on the ground. All right, so he's got the body locked down here, DC, or so it appears. This is not a guy you want anywhere near your back. Man, isn't it fun to watch this dude work on the mat?
He's unbelievable how fluid he is in his motions on the mat.
Oh, nice job working hard, posting, and getting back up. Oh, he lands another hook there. He's already landed several in the round. That one might have been the cleanest of the bunch.
He turned his chin, made his chin touch his shoulder with that beautiful hook. He really got all of himself into that hook, pivoted off the right hand, big left hook lands. What a great punch.
So 28 total strikes have landed for Leon Edwards.
Oh, big elbow. Right hand punch to the clinch. One takedown, he's in the defense. Then you start stringing them together, and one guy struggles.
Close guard.
Triangle
looks pretty tight, DC. I'm no Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt, but maybe not good here.
No, it looks like it's getting in deep. Oh!
Oh, he's got one hand in, one hand out. Now you're looking for defensively.
Well, he's staying pretty effective here, fighting off of his back. Nice strike landed there by the bottom by Edwards.
A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. Close guard.
Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Back to the feet now.
All right, you see his high-level footwork here, maybe trying to set up that hook shot at least potentially.
You can tell, John, he's setting a trap. He's trying to walk his opponent back into his hook side, his big power side. So he'll keep feinting out little punches with no intent to land, just to get his opponent where he needs him to be to land that kill shot.
Obvious limp there. His leg hurting for certain.
Look at him drive his shin into his opponent's body.
stuffs that takedown attempt without issue.
Every time these guys come together, man, you just hear the punches and everything landing. Both very powerful, very, very explosive. Good punch.
20 seconds to go. Edwards gets caught by that straight punch. Can't take too many more of those.
Oh, big elbow.
Jockeying for position in the clinch. Both fighters here trying to get a more dominant position.
Big kick.
Looking for that left hand, just missed.
That's the way to control the fight. Your skills. This round, I want to see the same thing, but even more.
All right, now we check out some of the action from that previous round, DC. How about the display of striking?
Just high level. I mean, you would think that we're watching a K-1 level kickboxing match opposed to being in the UFC. Both displayed great technical skills. Unbelievable strike.
All right, here we go as our next round gets underway. His strong leg packs so much power that even when he doesn't throw it full throttle, you see he's able to inflict damage. We'll see if he can keep it going here in this
He
round.
Doesn't throw it full power, but even when he faints it.
There as he lands, and maybe time to get the bonus checks ready.
I mean, this fight is about done. He's got him hurt very bad. Now he has to find one more strike to end the night.
That knee might have landed there. And yet another knee finds the target. Strong work there by Kamaru Usman. And those knees aren't just for effect. Those are doing real damage. Oh, these are some impactful. Oh, nice job to defend the takedown and scramble to his feet. And he connects with a punch there. We'll see if there's more where that came from.
Boxing, boxing, boxing.
All right, single collar tie now.
Big knee lands right in the opponent's midsection.
Ooh! Usman's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting changes levels now, DC.
Oh, man, he was in a single, got to a high crotch.
Oh, he's got the knee on the belly. Could be trouble defensively. All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Oh, nice work from the bottom. Tags him with the punch. Oh, you can hear the crowd reaction every time he lands another hook. The previous round, it was hooks and bunches. More of the same here.
More of the same, John. You watch a guy who's in a flow, who's in a rhythm, who's in a position where they don't feel like they could ever miss that shot. That's what we're witnessing tonight.
Well, you've got to be working off of your back. He's certainly doing so here. Nice punch. Close guard. Connects with a right. And he's back up. 94 total strikes have landed for Kamaru Usman. Landing with 72% accuracy tonight against Leon Edwards.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Strike to the body, really starting to connect. Oh, beautiful job with the ankle pick to get him down. Now we'll see where he chooses to go from here.
Got the ankle pick. Let's see how he advances from this position.
Ooh, what a punch.
A lot of power on display from Kamaru Usman as he lands yet again there.
Kamaru Usman showed in the Colby Covington fight. Not only is he the best world, he may just be the toughest welterweight the world because he went through the fire in order to retain that title.
Just missed with the left there.
This could change the fight. Another takedown lands. Now the guy's got armbar. He's attacking it on him. And attacking the armbar.
Nice job here staying busy off of his back. Nice offense from the bottom. Grounded pound strike there now. pressure being applied here.
Oh, right in the mouth.
Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. Lands the ground and pound strike.
Oh, nice right hand.
All right, side control now. Well, you gotta stay busy on the bottom. He's doing it here. Nice punch. Pretty good work with the strikes here off of his back by Kamaru Usman. Good movement by him here, transitioning very well on the ground. So.
Step for step, he's staying with his opponent in every transition.
Well, we'll see if he postures up and can get some of his ground strikes going here.
He did a great job securing that ankle, Vic, but he did not react fast enough to secure the top position.
And just like that, back to a standing position, we'll see who has the advantage. Nice strike to the midsection, glances. What a fight so far! All right, so there's the end of the round. The storyline over those previous 5 minutes, volume takedowns, offensive wrestling.
Yeah, this is an exhausting type of fight, not only for the offensive fighter, but also for the opponent. Always being under attack, always being defensive, always reacting starts to really wear at your gas tank. It's interesting to see who is more fresh going into the next round.
Oh, he lands another strike to the body, really starting to pile up these body shots here in the latter stages of this fight. You didn't see a lot of that in the earlier rounds, making up for lost time here. Nice punch by Kamaru Usman.
Oh, big head kick.
Oh, single collar tie here. Lands a big elbow there. Quick level change.
Oh, he went single. Rotate head outside. This dude's going for a ride. Big slam takedown. That was beautiful.
Usman's lower jaw very swollen now. Time to bite down on the mouthpiece and move forward. All right, bottom fighter here. Maybe looking to hip escape, DC. Close guard. Well, hard to win fights in mixed martial arts from the bottom, but nice work here in that position by Edwards. Oh, how about the speed on that reversal there? I mean, I know you can get out of some bad spots, but not with that type of speed.
You cannot allow him to get leverage on the bottom. What a sweep.
All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. Edwards gets back up, back into his comfort zone.
Big power punch land. Now we get back in range.
Single collar tie. Now he engages in a Muay Thai clinch. You better protect that head.
Great job securing the Muay Thai clinch. Watch for big knees to the body, and eventually him switch it up with a big knee to the head.
Well, we pull up the unofficial numbers here, and how about that? 153 total strikes have landed for Kamaru Usman. Well, and more often than not, when it's been thrown, it has landed a 73% accuracy rate against Leon Edwards. Oh, continuing to get the head kick home, and now his opponent in a world of trouble.
Such a sneaky head kick. He did not recognize it. It was coming high, and now he's got him hurt bad.
And he comes through with a big knee.
You hear the crowd react every time they come together because they...
understands the power that these guys are striking with.
All right, so he's landed some good shots tonight, but this is not a combo meal, right? No three-piece, no soda. It's one and done more often than not.
John, don't you come to me without a combo. I want the whole platter. Oh, platter. Oh, man, put some punches together. What a beautiful takedown.
Well, his wrestling has been a great equalizer thus far in his UFC career and gets the single leg takedown.
And you know that it's his shot. It's his shot of choice, a single leg takedown. And he's securing it, and he's doing it, and scored it over and over.
Well, as usual, suffocating work from the top here by Usman. All right, side control now. We'll see if he can advance position. All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape, or maybe look for a Kimura here.
Gets up again here, but hurting. That knee might have landed there. Oh, good series of knees by him there, working the head, working the body. He is going all over the place tonight.
He is using that knee to really dictate where the fight takes place.
Wow. And there's a big takedown. All right, working inside his opponent's guard here.
You cannot sit in these jiu-jitsu guys' guard. And you can't have one arm in, one arm out. Guys will start throwing up legs, chasing triangles.
All right, he's hanging out inside the closed guard of his opponent here, DC. You got to be careful. All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent, you got
to
be careful.
He's going to start trying to move to a submission here. It looks like he's trying to attack the arm triangle. Watch triangle, watch triangle. He's to push the arm to the side. Get his head against the back.
Nicely done. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. That's a good ground and pound by him here, certainly staying busy, and not just busy, but effective.
You can just throw punches to keep the referee off you. This guy is throwing punches to be effective, to throw damaging strikes. He's doing a fantastic job.
Working off of his back here, looks like he may try to hip escape, and he landed the right hand there. Well, you know, I don't like the gi very much, but I have an appreciation and a healthy one for these type of transitions.
You can tell he's been in a gi at some point in his life with the way that he moves so freely.
I'm skipping jiu-jitsu next week, too. A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. There's the end of the round, so it was a huge strike to the head that stunned his opponent and nearly got him out of there.
Yeah, that was a big moment. A big strike lands, his opponent's on wobbly legs. That is exactly what you want to see as you're walking back to your stool. Your opponent staggering back to his corner and being hopeful that he can get it back together before the start of the next round.
All right, so here we go. Fourth round is underway. What is the fighter's mentality when you enter those seminal championships?
You understand that you are getting close now. The night is almost over. The goal is within reach now. 15 minutes down, 10 to go. You tell yourself you can do anything in 10 minutes.
Man, is he timing his shots well here tonight, DC. Oh, he's going to hit him, DC.
Oh, man, he got that.
Some serious power to pick up another man and promptly put him in his place. Big opportunity now for him here on the ground. Close guard. Well, the ground and pound has been on point tonight. Good work here by Usman. Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do.
He's going to start looking to land big shots from the top.
All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position up the bottom.
Oh, looking to land the leg kick. That one checked. Oh, a little single collar tie there.
Beautiful punch.
And both guys really throwing with authority. Oh, over the top. This fight's going to be over, DC.
What a great way of mixing up his attack. He didn't stay the course. He mixed it up. He went high when he was going to go low. And now he's got him hurt very badly.
Might be a submission attempt here, champ.
I mean, you can't. Now he's attacking the triangle.
Triangle looks pretty tight, DC. I'm no Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt, but maybe not good here.
No, it looks like it's getting in deep.
All right, so he postures up, and he's out. hammer fist. Man, this is some serious ground and pound here, DC. He's not just staying busy for the sake of staying busy. These strikes are doing damage.
Oh, yeah. No pity pat to this guy. This guy's trying to land. He's trying to land effective strikes.
Side control now, DC. A lot of options at his disposal from here. Usman's got a bruise starting to appear on that right side of his body now. Oh, useful strike on the ground that was. All right, good movement by him here on the ground. He really is a master of these transitions.
He is a master of movement on the ground. You never know where he's going to be.
Oh, he's landed a high number of total strikes here in the latter stages of this fight. He's really picked up the pace and landing far more strikes than he did in previous rounds. Side control now. Just over 2 minutes to go. All right, so he's got him in the north-south position now, DC. If you're the top fighter in this situation, what are you trying to do offensively?
I'm trying to force some sort of action from my opponent. You want him to turn to his knees to either give you the guillotine choke or allow you to try to chase the back. It's a tough position to control in, but there are options for finishes and are options for positional advancement if you're patient.
He jumps on a headlock. We call this in wrestling just a headlock, and if you're not careful, you can get stuck in an arm triangle.
Watch triangle, watch triangle.
Now he's okay. Now he can escape.
Oh, you gotta watch him attack his submissions. He throws the legs up to try to get a triangle choke here. Watch triangle, watch triangle.
Oh, man, that was slick.
Side control now. Oh, really nice work to keep busy off of his back as he lands some more offense here for Bob. Ground and pound strike is true. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. All right, working inside the now open guard of his opponent. Uh-oh.
Throwing up a triangle. The guy on his back is very good at submissions. If he's not careful here, he's going to get stuck and he will have to submit. Nice straight punch.
Oh, he has landed a high volume of strikes in this round and really hasn't let up when it comes to his aggressiveness. The striking has been on point every step of the way. Careful to not gas out, but you gotta like the output here down the stretch. Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. All right, let's now look back at some of the action from that round. He went headhunting, landed, nearly got the finish, too.
A lot of coaches tell you don't headhunt. In this case, he's been headhunting, and he landed a big enough shot to truly put his opponent on notice.
Fighters can't keep up this type of aggression and pace, but you don't have to worry about this guy. He hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. Well, it's one thing to have length. It's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Evans. Usman's tough as it gets, but how about the size of that bruise starting to form on his right side?
Still a nice body kick land.
And now he's hooked.
That one was shot, and if you take one,
series of strikes for him. They're staying busy and staying accurate.
I mean, the accuracy is unbelievable.
And they separate. Beautiful movement, hip work on the ground here. are just outstanding with the transitions.
He is not
Oh, he's got a lot of different arm bars he can go to attacking here. So you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long.
Nice hammer fist. All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
Oh, reversal here, DC.
What a way to switch the position. Fantastic movement by the bottom fighter.
Posturing up now.
And now the damage is about to start.
All right, operating inside the closed guard now. All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent. You got to be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy.
Continuing to work out of the half guard.
Lands with the ground and pound. Now Usman really getting the ground and pound going, DC. You got to hip escape. You got to do something to get out of the
move.
Edwards has got his arm under the chin, going for a guillotine now. DC, dream fight for the fans, maybe not so much for the judges. It's been back and forth.
It's been so close. I would not want to be sitting at the judges' table right now. I don't know who's winning this fight.
Oh, he's got it going now. Nice connection there, DC.
Another punch land.
All right, he closes the distance, gets the single collar tie.
Oh, man, this is hard to watch.
Volume uppercuts in the clinch, and all of them serving to slow. Done by Edwards. Close guard. Lands a strike now from the bottom. Nice work there by Edwards. All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. A lot of top pressure being applied here. Lands with the ground and pound here. Well, you see all the grappling repetitions here. Just beautiful movement, seamless transitions on them.
Over and over, these guys are doing things that you see in every jiu-jitsu gym around the country.
Knee strike there, interrupted by Usman. All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie. Oh, and now the underhook, DC.
He's got the underhook, he's got the far side post. If you're the opponent, you have got to get out of here. Over and over. Down, another takedown land. And now he has a headlock trying to pin his opponent's back down flat onto the mat. Look from the transition to an arm triangle to try to chase the finish.
And he's out. I love watching this guy move on the ground. Another nice transition there.
Such a high-level grappler. You don't see that very often.
Of the fight. All right, side control now, DC. You know he's in his element on the ground. A lot of tricks up his sleeve.
A lot of tricks.
The official decision is in. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for decision. The judges score the contest 49-46, 48-47, and 48-47. Play the winner by unanimous decision, and still the undisputed UFC welterweight champion of the world, Leon Rocky Edwards.
All right, so there he is. He came in the hunted. He remains as such. Congrats to the still UFC welterweight champion. Big effort out of the incumbent here tonight.
He has so much pride in being the UFC champion.
Welterweight championship showdown between Leon Edwards and Darren the Gorilla Till. Proudly representing Liverpool, England, also has some roots in Brazil. Here is Darren Till, looking to preserve his spot as welterweight contender here tonight.
Darren Till is a phenomenal fighter, a guy that's willing to fight anybody. The interview where he's in the octagon, he says, just line them up, I'll fight them all.
Yeah.
I will fight each and every one of them. Darren Till has that quality of battle that just draws you in. But what
ready.
So here we go as round one gets underway. Two world-class level strikers here, and the expectation is we're going to get a kickboxing match here in the octagon.
Yes, we are going to get a striking match. One guy is very good at kicks. The other guy has unbelievable hands. Let's see what type of attack is going to win the battle of two great stand-up fighters.
Man, he's timing his shots nicely. It's like Tom Brady out there. He hasn't missed the target.
I mean, you insist on bringing in Tom Brady. Stop it. John, stop it.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the cover. Oh, big punch land.
Oh, and he gets tagged. Beautiful combination there, and I'm not sure how many more of those power shots he can take, honestly.
The night is almost over. If you keep getting hit with punches like this, you are going to sleep. Big kick.
Trying to kick the leg out. Oh, he tags him with the straight hand there. Nice job. Whoa!
Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
And a knee. Oh, straight right.
Beautiful body kick land right under the elbow.
Till gets hit with a kick. So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Leon Edwards.
That one struck in. Nice strike.
He's looking to land the right, just out of range. Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense? Lands a big elbow there. Body.
There's no give on that leg kick.
Oh!
Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick.
Single collar tie now.
Oh, big elbow.
Just misses there with the left. Till's kick looked like it might have been a good one, but it gets blocked. Try to establish that jab. Oh, nice strike landed there by Till. Just over 2 minutes now to go. Till's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Just out of range with the straight left hand. Oh, that right hand is on point. Right punch is good. The left also flush. And he connects with a punch there. We'll see if there's more where that came from.
Boxing, boxing, boxing. I mean, he's cutting him down to size with a beautiful leg kick.
Oh, that is a huge shot there, DC. I'm not sure how he stayed upright.
I mean, when you get hit with a shot like that, to stay standing shows and talks to your toughness. He's throwing every part of himself into this big leg kick.
Oh! Head kick! Oh, straight right! Oh! All right, single collar tie now.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this?
Under a minute now to go. Oh, beautiful jab there from Leon Edwards. And if you don't know the name Leon Edwards, you're going to start to hear his name increasingly. Truly one of the better fighters in this world.
Absolutely. And the reason you don't know his name is because he's more of a quiet guy. He's very reserved. He used to be at AKA for months, and you barely knew that Rocky was even there. He was just there to get his work in, as he's doing his work now inside the octagon. Look at the whip action that comes from him throwing that kick.
Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Oh, and there's that inside leg kick. And just slap yourself hard on the inside of your leg and tell me how that feels.
I mean, it really hurts. And that's the soft part of your leg. So you land that over and over again, guys will have a very tough time maneuvering out of a lot of the techniques you throw at.
5 minutes in the books. Right, there's the end of the round. So it was a huge strike to the head that stunned his opponent and nearly got him out of it.
Yeah, that was a big moment. A big strike lands, his opponent's on wobbly legs. That is exactly what you want to see as you're walking back to your stool. Your opponent staggering back to his corner and being hopeful that he can get it back together before the start of the next round.
All right, here we go with the start of round two. Leon Edwards versus Darren Till. Edwards' kick blocked. Unable to connect with a right hook. Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. Just out of the range with that right hand.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks. Nice punch lands over the top.
That is a hard left hand that lands for Leon Edwards. And as usual, DC, letting his fighting do the talking tonight.
Letting his fighting do the talking, man. He's all business. He's a businessman. He's here to win, go back to England, and do his thing with his family. He's not going to be on TV hooting and hollering. He's a guy that's here to do his job and then go back home until he gets the title fight.
72 total strikes have now landed for Leon Rocky Edwards. And landing with 50% accuracy tonight against Darren Till.
Leg kick. Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Takedown, perfect entry there, and finally he gets his first takedown of the fight, and they say, if at first you don't succeed, try again, was able to get him down there.
Persistence pays, and that's what we saw with this young man. Over and over, he shot for takedowns, he tried to fix it up, and he got defended. But eventually, he got it done. Now, what does he do with this top control? He's attacking the neck himself.
And he's out. Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do now.
He's going to start looking to land big shots from the top.
Oh, he's got the ground and pound going now. Till's lower jaw is extremely swollen now. Oh, so an interesting decision there as he decides to stand up and relinquish the dominant position.
You don't really stand after you take a head kick like this. That is such toughness to even be on his feet right now.
Well, he has really picked up the pace here in round two. Much more aggressive than we saw in round one, and now starting to find himself in the pocket.
Look at how he turns his hip over when he throws that kick.
Just over 2 minutes to go in round two.
Big leg kick land.
Oh, huge kick to that lead leg.
Good stick.
Timing his shots nicely here, champ.
He's doing a great job of mixing everything up and using a lot of diverse strikes.
Shooting for the takedown here.
Nice kick.
Tags him with the straight. Nice job there by Till. So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll as this fight goes on.
Nice loop and punch.
Tried to set up the straight left, but he missed. Right hand upstairs. Continues to mix it up, going with the head, mixing in some body shots. He's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with the...
He's going to start trying to move to a submission here. It looks like he's trying to attack the arm.
20 seconds left. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Close guard. All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long.
DC, it didn't take him long to find his range here tonight, huh?
His timing is on point.
And that's the end of round number two.
All right, no Telestrator for the champ tonight, but that's okay. He'll still talk you through the replays. Body kicks for days, man.
I mean, body kicks for days, but I got to be honest, John. If we don't incorporate a Telestrator into this game, this may be my only version of EA UFC.
He's all over you with the submission attempts. Great job with your defense, but we got to do better. I want you to put him on the defense.
All right, next round is underway, DC. We talked about his powerful kicks, how he attacks all sides of the body, the head, the legs. Pretty good start for him tonight.
That was so impressive to see someone fight almost predominantly with their legs and have that level of success.
Well, just as he did in the previous round, he continues to connect on a high volume of strikes. And a good sign, too, doesn't seem to be slowing down whatsoever. He blocks the punch. Oh, nice punch there by Till. Oh, nice connection by him there with the right hand.
The right hand is the dominant hand, and you can see how well he throws it.
Edwards gets hit by that leg kick. May not be a bad idea to start to check some of these. Oh! And now his opponent in a world of trouble.
Such a sneaky head kick. He did not recognize it. God, now he's got him hurt bad.
The number's 126 total strikes have landed for Leon Edwards. Landing at a 54% clip tonight against Darren Till. All right, well, he's landed some good shots tonight, but there's no three-piece, there's no soda. More often than not, it's one and done.
He's not even getting a combination. I mean, if you're going to sit there at the drive-thru, order a combination, take the soda with your food, give him the right hand behind the jab, give him the hook behind the right hand, jab, right hand, hook, that's two pieces of chicken, and a biscuit, finish him off with the uppercut. That is your soda. I mean, come on, man. Let this guy have the whole thing. Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Lands a nice straight punch there. Now we'll see if he can follow it up.
What do you follow up a great punch like this with? I'm excited to see what happens. He's just being more aggressive, and because he's being more aggressive and more loose with his strikes, he's landing.
Like he might have landed there. Instead, a swing and a miss by Edwards. Well, he is really starting to apply a lot of pressure here down.
Oh, that was a big takedown. Is this the one that's going to break him?
All right, he's in a half-guard position here, DC, and in a good spot to dole out a lot of damage, I would think. A
lot of damage can be done from the half-guard. You sit back on that leg, you press down into your opponent, you drop elbows, you drop punches. What is very key is you controlling the underhook on the far side. If you give up that underhook, your opponent can use the half guard to build up to an elbow, sweep, or just chase down a single leg. Look at him working at trying to shut the liver down.
Just over 2 minutes to go. Oh, big knee to the body, man alive.
Every time these guys come together, man, you just hear the punches and everything landing. Both very powerful, very, very explosive.
Edwards gets caught with that punch. Trying to establish that jab once again.
This guy still attached to his body. The last time I saw an uppercut like that, it was opening versus the gun. And you know, it's killing.
Good series of strikes for him there. Staying busy and staying accurate.
I mean, the accuracy is unbelievable.
About as good a one-strike finish as we've seen here in the UFC in recent memory. I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming. So a big, big win for him here tonight. Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 45 seconds of the third round. Declare the winner by knockout and still the undisputed UFC welterweight champion of the world, Leon Rocky Edwards.
So this So here is the pride of Simpsonville, South Carolina, Stephen Wonderboy Thompson. Twice he has challenged for UFC gold. Prevailing wisdom is if he can win this fight here tonight, he'll be back on that short list of contenders.
You look at Stephen Thompson and you almost feel like you'll see him at a church choir more than you'll see him in the octagon. He looks so innocent. But when you're in there, you are in there with an absolute killer. Stephen Thompson has an ability to slide out of range as you enter and counter you. Really, really quick. He counters like a viper. He's so fast with his counterattacks. That right hand is unbelievable, and he fights in that traditional karate stance, which makes it difficult to try and piece the puzzle together when you're in front of the Wonderboy.
And of course, the last man to beat Robert Whittaker, I submit to you Stephen Wonderboy Thompson, back at UFC 170, one of the bigger knockouts of his career in 2014. Well, I'm excited for this one. This is a kickboxer of the highest order. He has so many different kicks and punches in his arsenal and figures to try to keep this on the feet here tonight.
The beautiful thing that he does is throws that front push kick to create distance when a guy starts to get too close and wants to wrestle with it. He throws it, and the moment you're back at his range, he starts to blast high kicks. He doesn't always intend on landing it, but he beats up your arm with high kick after high kick after high kick. As you get desperate, you start to run into knees, and he does not need much space to land a knockout punch. This guy is one of the best strikers we've ever seen in the UFC.
And if you don't find the striking range early against this guy, you could be in real trouble. Our tale of the tape for this welterweight championship fight. Thompson is 9 years the elder. He will have a one-inch reach advantage. All right, now for the introductions, we go to Bruce Buffer. We've got two classically trained strikers here. Any chance this fight actually goes to the ground?
This fight does not go to the ground. This one will be fought in the pocket. Two guys will stand in front of each other. They will trade punches. They will trade kicks. It's going to be a classic matchup that you normally see inside of a ring. We get it in the octagon. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one up?
Spinning back fist. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman. What a body kick. Look at him. Trying to shut the liver down. Nice punch land over the top. He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks. Nice body kick right under the elbow.
And they're exchanging leather early.
He has a commitment to kicking tonight, and it shows. I mean, he's cutting down the size with these beautiful leg kicks.
Double jab there by Thompson. All right, so he continues to use his jab effectively here, DC. He gets that hand to the target pretty quickly.
I mean, just right away, blasting the jab after jab after jab.
Edwards gets the double leg takedown now. Just over 3 minutes to go. All right, half guard position here. We'll see what he can do with it. A lot of weapons at his disposal from this dominant position.
Oh, man. I feel for a wrestler, this is the most dominant position in all of fighting because wrestlers love control.
Right.
And to have your upper body free and your leg able to hold your opponent in position. Now the guy's got arm bar. He's attacking it on him.
Anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. Outstanding ground and pound here. Somewhat of a lost art in MMA, at least in terms of making sure that every strike counts. Not an issue for him.
He's making every single one of them count. He is not pity patting. He's not touching. Every punch that lands, he wants you to feel.
So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Leon Edwards. Beautiful 1-2 from Leon Edwards. I really enjoy watching this guy fight. I think as technical and fundamentally sound a fighter as any in the welterweight division.
Yeah, very sound fundamentally. And we've seen Leon go from a very green prospect into the man that he is today. He's so well-versed in all areas of MMA. You watch him now as he's on the cusp of the UFC title fight.
Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. 90 seconds to go in round one. Oh, big kick lands flush. Both of these guys going all out. High action fight here.
Oh! Oh, nice right hand.
All right, he closes the distance, gets the single collar tie. Straight right. Able to check that kick as well.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Beautiful entry as he gets the takedown late in the round two, which could have an impact on the judges potentially.
Absolutely. You want to leave an impression in the judge's mind. And when you walk back to your corner, when you get up from a dominant position, almost want to wave at the judges and say, I got it.
Right. Closed guard here. He's very comfortable here working off of his back, DC. Oh, the ground and pound strikes continue to rain down. The opponent better move out of harm's way or the referee's going
to
stop this.
He better start to move. And when his opponent starts to pause,
sure the extent to which he has recovered, but we do see the end of the round. DC, talk us through the replay.
Well, he's a tough guy. He's going to make it to the stool. He's going to survive unless you put him completely out of there. Unfortunately, he's in there with a guy that does have that ability.
Let's get to round two. Well, it's one thing to have length. It's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Thompson.
Big, Paul.
Oh, that is a huge shot right there, DC. You don't want to eat too many more of those.
No, and he needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Well, he's landed some good shots tonight, but there's no three-piece, there's no soda. More often than not, it's one and done.
He's not even getting a combination. I mean, if you're going to sit there at the drive-thru, order a combination, take the soda with your food, give him the right hand behind the jab, give him the hook behind the right hand, jab, right hand, hook, that's two pieces of chicken and a biscuit, finish him off with the uppercut, that is your soda. I mean, come on, man, let this guy have the whole thing.
58 total strikes, and now landed for Leon Rocky Edwards. And a pretty good clip tonight, DC, landing with 64% accuracy against Stephen Thompson. jab there from Leon Edwards. And if you don't know the name Leon Edwards, you're going to start to hear his name increasingly. Truly one of the better fighters in this division.
Absolutely. And the reason you don't know his name is because he's more of a quiet guy. He's very reserved. He used to be at AKA for months, and you barely knew that Rocky was even there. He was just there to get his work in, as he's doing his work now inside
the Edwards gets the double leg takedown. Nice job there disguising his entry. All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
All right, feet on the hips here. Edwards is back in half court.
And now he has a headlock trying to pin his opponent's back down flat onto the mat. Look for him to transition to an arm triangle to try to chase the finish. Watch triangle.
And he's out. Thompson's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling. Oh, he gets back up. The question is for how long? Well, his corner was pretty urgent after round one. A little bit lackluster there in that opening round. He has certainly picked up the pace here, and as a result, he has taken control of this second round. Oh, nice jab by him there, and I guess on the other side, hard to get your offense going when your head keeps getting snapped back like a Pez dispenser.
Every time he tries to go forward and use his own offense, the jab is stopping him in his tracks. He's doing a great job of fighting behind him.
Well, he is clearly faded in this one. I'm not talking about the high and tight skin fade on my man, Daniel Cormier. He got stunned earlier in the round, and mentally, I feel like he checked out a little bit.
He hasn't been able to build back and fight the way that we're used to seeing him fight. He needs to take a breath, take a moment, and get back to work.
And he comes through with a big knee.
That knee hurt him. Every time these guys come together, man, you just hear the punches and everything landing. Both very powerful, very, very explosive.
There by Edwards. DC, didn't take him long to find his range here tonight, huh?
His timing is on point.
Nice 1-2 there.
Oh.
Oh, straight right.
That one was thrown to end the fight.
Yep. Oh! Massive kick to the head. Kick to the body here. That one appeared to be blocked. And he connects with a punch there. We'll see if there's more where that came from.
Boxing. You gotta check these low leg kicks.
Again, going back to the jab just out of range. Nice punch by Edwards. The combination lands for him. He is really putting his strikes together tonight.
I mean, he's feeling himself tonight, John. He's doing a great job of putting everything together.
Well, he has landed a high volume of strikes in this round and really hasn't let up when it comes to his aggressiveness. The striking has been on point every step of the way. Careful to not gas out, but you gotta like the output here down the stretch. Single leg takedown attempt here, and get you out of your seat. Beautifully done by him there.
Oh, man. I jumped up and down. hard fight. You don't see single legs this good unless you're watching a real high-level wrestler.
All right, well, his kicking game was outstanding in that round. We'll see if his opponent can make the adjustments, but take us through the replays before we get there.
It's always weird to watch a young fighter start to come into his own. Early in his career, he did not have this ability. He did not have the ability to dictate and control fights with his legs. Now he does, and he looks like a future champion in the making.
All right, next round is underway, DC. We talked about his powerful kicks, how he attacks all sides of the body, the head, the legs. Pretty good start for him, too.
That was so impressive to see someone fight almost predominantly with their legs and have that level of success.
Nice job by Leon Edwards going to the kicking game now. Certainly earned the respect with his hands. Now changes the look.
Full on mixed martial arts.
Yeah.
He can do it all. He's a fantastic striker. A guy that can mix it up. A guy that knows exactly where the opening is and isn't shy to take that open. That's a big strike right there.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there.
Oh, big head kick lands.
Thompson's lower jaw very swollen now. Time to bite down on the mouthpiece and move forward. So the numbers thus far, 121 total strikes have landed for Leon Edwards. And landing with 63% accuracy. How about that? Against Steven Thompson. Oh, huge strike right there. I'm not sure how many more of these his opponent can take.
Massive shot that he landed. Great job.
All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent, gotta be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. Man, isn't it fun to watch this dude work on the mat?
He's unbelievable how fluid he is in his motion on the mat.
Oh, wow, that happened quickly as the fighter reverses position there on the ground.
Unbelievable position change. Wow, what a transition.
Edwards has got full mount now. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC.
He jumps on a headlock. We call this in wrestling just a headlock. And if you're not careful, you can get stuck in an arm triangle. A triangle. Oh, man, that was slick.
Under 3 minutes now to go on the round. Back to the feet now. Fighters can't keep up this type of aggression and pace, but you don't have to worry about this guy. He hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight.
Beautiful body kick. Oh, what a punch.
Man.
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now. Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Well, he continues to mix it up beautifully on the feet. Nice inside leg kicks there by Edwards.
He got him.
Nice double leg takedown attempt there, and you got to think that's something that's going to give him confidence moving forward in this fight.
A lot of confidence when it happens that easily. He took a shot, he got a takedown. What now will stop him from doing it over and over again?
Oh, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent.
Back and forth we go here.
All right, so he continues to land that patented jab and keeping his opponent at bay.
You can know that it's coming, but until you're in there with him, the speed and the power of that jab is something you can't really prepare for. Look at how he turns his hip over when he throws that kick. He's very tricky when he throws that body kick.
Thompson's hook shot there looked pretty good, but blocked by the defense. And a nice jab there, champ.
The jab was a lost art in mixed martial arts. Guys have found it, and they're fighting behind it real well. He's got to be careful dipping his head when he's throwing that jab. You take more of these leg kicks, you will not be able to beat them.
Man, he's time to
insist on bringing in Tom Brady to stop him.
Edwards gets caught with that punch.
Trying to control posture here. Now trying to.
How about those 5 minutes?
Whoa.
All right, and there's the horn, and you hear the collective sigh from the crowd. They're all watching that lip, and we're monitoring it as well. Nasty, nasty gash. It's only getting worse by the moment. Doctor called in here. We'll see if he stops the fight. All right, now we check out some of the action from that previous round, DC. How about the display of striking?
Just high level. I mean, you would think that we're watching a K1 level kickboxing match opposed to being in the UFC. Both displayed great technical skills, unbelievable striking.
Let's go fight.
Oh, that's a good right hand.
There's no tell on that leg kick.
Well, he's been pretty accurate tonight. He's landed some significant strikes, but his corner's looking for him to mix it up a little bit more.
Oh, there as he lands, and maybe time to get the bonus checks ready.
I mean, this fight is about done. He's got him hurt very bad with his head kick. Now he has to find one more strike to end the night. Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Kick to the body now. That one won't land. Whoa!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad. He's in trouble. He's getting lit up.
Oh! Oh, man, this guy kicks like a mule.
So hard. He kicks so hard every time you see him drive his shin into his opponent. He can't take any of those kicks.
Back and forth we go. This fight's gonna be over, DC.
What a great play. Didn't stay the course. He mixed it up. He went high, low, and now he's got him hurt very badly.
Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's gotta grab that head, or he's going to get blasted.
Close guard. Wonder Boy going to work here from guard and doing a pretty good job, I might add. Nice hammer fist. And back to his feet. Well, he's certainly keeping busy, DC, connecting with most of the punches he's thrown.
I mean, punches in bunches. He's doing a great job.
Well-placed kick there by Edwards.
Big punch from the clinch. I mean, over and over, he is taking these strikes to the head.
Oh, he's really starting to apply pressure on his opponent here. Different approach here in the last couple rounds, and it's the exact sense of urgency that you want to see from a fighter. Take the judges out of it.
Oh, that's a nice strike.
Oh! And just like that, the fight is over.
He got him! What a performance!
Pinpoint strike to end this fight. It landed flush. I'm not even sure the opponent only saw it coming, and before he could recover, the referee was in to stop the fight. So a huge knockout victory for that fighter here tonight. All right, DC, no telestrator tonight, but we're going to get you some highlights from this one. This was a fight that had it all, and for my money, his best performance to date.
His best performance to date in the biggest moment. In the biggest moment, you got to show up, and that's exactly what he did tonight. He used every bit of his skill to get the job done.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Murgliata has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 24 seconds of round number 4. Declaring the winner by knockout and new undisputed UFC welterweight champion of the world, Stephen Wonderboy Thompson.
All right, so he dedicated decades of his life.